السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, thanks God, He gave us another opportunity to reach Ramadan 1444. Another opportunity. For me, it's very precious and very important. Just using mathematics and the odds, could be last Ramadan or could be one of the last few of Ramadans. I'm taking it seriously, and I hope, after doing everything I can to reach the end of it and achieve the af from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to forgive all my sins, all my shortcoming, and to wipe out my records, which I'm sure full of mistakes, shortcomings, sins, and hopefully we're truly celebrate the Eid with this forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It would be the biggest reward. So happy Ramadan. Hopefully we'll be able to talk every day or every night and share together some food of thought or food for thoughts. And I'm gonna try to leave to the experts everything related to fiqh of siyam. And alhamdulillah, all the masajid and the khutaba and the scholars, also the media, the internet, the YouTube, are full of speeches, talks. Some of them are really traditional, about the importance of the fasting and the taqwa achieved at the end of the month, and so on. I will stay away from anything related to fiqh, and for a simple reason that I lack the knowledge. It's not my specialty. As you know, I'm a physician practitioner, a cardiologist to be precise, and that's a field which I spent my life doing. Also, this month coming with a package, which we see it every year, so don't be surprised. For those who do it either from ignorance or from irritation or from ego and so on, the month will come with fighting about sighting the moon and if it's accepted by astronomy or has to be sightseeing and so on, all the way to sighting the moon of the Shawwal, the same arguments and the same disagreement, and the location of Salat al-Eid and so on. This is happens every year, not to mention Zakat al-Fitr, also big fighting if you can pay it by money or by grain and dates, etc. So we have to accept the facts. There's a spectrum from the literalist with the literal interpretation to those who use the spirit of the law and the spirit of the Sharia. Anyway, we will not waste any time on that thing. We'll leave the immature people to fight. For us, this is a month of peace and month of love, the month of compassion, and the month of caring, the month of sympathy, the month of empathy, the month of charity, and helping the poor and the needy and the refugee and the disaster-stricken areas and so on. Of course, as a personal trainer, I have to watch what the myself, the community, my family, and so on. I have to emphasize the ibadat to make the salah perfect on time, better in congregation, and punctuality is very important in that regard. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Perfect timing, you have to wait for it. And it's a meeting with Creator of heaven and earth. It's a very important meeting. Look at it that way. You are waiting to talk to God, waiting to God, to your Creator. Of course, the ibadat includes salah and siyam, which we, inshallah, will do, and the zakah. This is a month where you have to give whatever you save money, 2.5% if a whole year passed, and the money has to be above nisab, which probably over $100 and so. And of course, you give as much also in charity, sadaqah. And the two words are used exchangeably, zakah and sadaqah, but we know zakah is the 2.5%. The sadaqah is more like a charity, which you give as much as you want and in all occasions. Of course, the ibadat include thinking about hajj and other things. Also, we're not going to talk about this. Alhamdulillah, the specialist will, in the masjid or on the TV or the media and so on, they will dwell on it. But for us, I see weaknesses in our behavior, our character. There's a lot of flaws. And our dealing and wheeling, there is major flaws. As a matter of fact, many of the brothers who reverted to Islam, this testimony, I have heard it on the media, more than one, oh, alhamdulillah, I knew Islam from the books and from the Quran, and if it was meeting a Muslim, I will probably never became a Muslim. Islam spread through the world of the righteous people with their smile, with their honesty, with their fulfilling their promises and punctuality and all these moral characters. They did not become Muslim by philosophy or by arguments to prove this or disprove this or debates. Never. It was through moral values and through character and conduct. And this is very weak in our education, our upbringing. I don't want to talk anything negative, so we need to improve in this aspect. And inshallah, we'll try to revisit the etiquette, Islamic etiquette and ethics and moral values and principles. And hopefully we will cover important ones. And we have done this also in the past. Also, this is a month which we can use it for detoxification, to cleanse our mind, our body, our heart from all the ills and the addictions. For the children, this is a month to stay away from screen and TV and dwell on the family, eat together around the dinner, iftar, talk about the problems and the issues and the facing in the school, friends, bullying, etc., etc., through quiet discussion and finding solutions and answers. So this is a time of going to the masjid, making the prayers in congregation. Also, that time will take you away from spending that much hours on the screen. So Ramadan is a good opportunity for detox. Alhamdulillah, we don't drink, we don't use drugs, And some of us, we pray for them to quit smoking. This is also the month which can help you to get rid of that poison, nicotine, and which can destroy your body. So this is a month of detoxification. And it's not the month of laziness or anger when you're hungry. Many people, when they are hungry, they become wild, like a beast, angry, short fuse, explode in the face of wife or husband and children. So this is not the right way. This is a month of serenity, quietness, and humbleness, and everything good and positive. So we have to pay attention to that. And it's not the month of laziness. Most of what happened glorious in our history happened in the month of Ramadan. So this month is a month of activity. We should get rid of laziness and couch potato and flipping TV stations, watching too much news. This is a month of exercising and walking and burning calories and bringing your body mass index to 25. There is apps which can calculate your BMI according to your age and weight and height. So see where you stand. I bet you most of us are close to obesity, and obesity is not you look fat. It's a disease which can affect your life and affect your organs, and diabetes, high blood pressure, you name it. So this is a month also of a diet. Unfortunately, the back home, the tradition, when the iftar comes, they pig out. They eat cows and camels and all kind of dessert and sweets. No wonder that the Muslims in the third world countries are inflicted with very bad diseases. It's epidemic, like as bad as corona, of diabetes and high blood pressure and obesity, and destroying their knees and joints. And many of them, they go to Europe and change their knee joint or hip joints, etc. So this is a month of eating like the diet of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam: few dates, a lot of fluids, water and or milk. And this is the diet. It's not the month of pigging out. This is wrong. So we have to fix this problem. Also, this is a month of charity work, the month of volunteering work. And we have talked many times that volunteerism is synonymous with happiness. So we have to spend more time the beautification of the masjid or around it, or in the school and activity, and joining other civics associations and so on to do good things. The Muslim definition is a good doer. So let us do that in this month of Ramadan. I encourage first myself, you know, to do this, and encourage my family and my children and grandchildren to do Ramadan the right way. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.